Hello guys, welcome back to Chenda DIY, and today's video I'll be showing you how to crochet hooded cowl top. It is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. For this top I made for size small, but I also showing you how to make it bigger and how to measuring it on your body. Okay, now let's get started. First thing first, we are going to make the front part of the top. To begin, make a slip knot. Then make 37 chains. It is equal 7 inches length. For this top pattern, we are working on the length way. So for the number of the foundation chains, is the height of the top. If you guys want your top more longer, please add more chains. And after you got your desired length, this is how you're measuring it on your body. Like I said, if you guys want your top more longer, please add more chains. And next, we are going to make the ribbing stitch. As you can see, this is the front side or the right side of the foundation chains. Then flip the foundation chains and we are going to working on the wrong side or the back side of the chains. You can see the small bump at the back side of the chains. It is where we are going to insert the hook through. To begin for row 1, skip 1 chain and make single crochet into the second chain. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the small bump. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. Keep repeating this until you got 15 stitches of single crochet. Then I will meet you back again. As you can see, this is the top part of the stitch. It looks like a V shape. And at the bottom part of the stitch, we have the same shape too. This is what it looks like after you got 15 stitches of single crochet. If you guys want the bottom ribbing of the top more longer, you can add more stitches. And then don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at your last stitch of single crochet. It is easy to know where to start making this stitch again. And next, we are going to continue make half double crochet stitch. To make half double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the small bump, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And this is how we make half double crochet. Keep making half double crochet into every chain until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 2. For chain 2, we don't count as a stitch. Then turn your work, and as you can see the V part at the top of the stitch, we are going to work in the stitch into the back loop only. Keep making half double crochet into the back loop only until you reach the stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the stitch near stitch marker, then remove the stitch marker and we are going to make the single crochet stitch, but we only working the stitch into the back loop only like we make with half double crochet. Keep making single crochet back loop only into every stitch until you have one last stitch, then I will meet you back again. And after you have one last stitch, then make single crochet into both loop. And this is what the second row looks like. Next, for row 3, chain 1. For chain 1, we don't count as a stitch, then turn your work. And we are going to make single crochet back loop only into every stitch until you got 15 stitches of single crochet or until you reach the stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the stitch marker, then we are going to continue make half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you have one last stitch, then I will meet you back again. And after you have one last stitch, then make half double crochet into both loop. And this is what the third row looks like. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 and row 3 until you reach row 9. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 9. For the width of this row 9, it is equal 2.5 inches. So for the number of the rows, it's the width of the top. If you guys want your top more bigger, please add more rows. And this is how you're measuring it on your body. You have to measuring it from the underneath of your underarm until it reaches the shoulder part. It means that you have to make it away from your underarm part, as you can see. And next, we are going to make the shoulder part, which is the strap of the top. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is for row 10, chain 2. Turn your work, and we are going to make increase by make 2 half double crochet back loop only into the same loop. After you got 2 half double crochet in the same loop, don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this first stitch so you don't miss it. Then continue make half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you reach the stitch marker or until you reach the stitch near single crochet stitch. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the stitch marker or the single crochet stitch, then continue with single crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. And this is what the row 10 looks like. And next, for row 11, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet back loop only for 15 stitches. Then make half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you have one last stitch. And after you have one last stitch, then we are going to make increase again by make 2 half double crochet in the same loop. After you got 2 half double crochet in the same loop, and now we got 2 increasing rows, and this is what it looks like. We want the curved edge at the corner of the underarm part. And next, we are going to continue make the foundation chains until you reach the top of the shoulder. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is and make 22 chains. It is equal 5.5 inches length. If you guys want your strap more longer, please add more chains. And this is what it looks like after you got 22 chains. And then continue add 2 more chains. It is for the turning chain. Next, for row 12, skip 2 chains and make half double crochet into the third chain. Keep making half double crochet into every chain until you reach the end of the chain or until you reach the half double crochet stitch, then we meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the chain, then continue make half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you reach the stitch marker or until you reach the single crochet stitch. Then continue make single crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And next, for row 13 until row 20, you just repeat like row 2 and row 3. It means that you have to make no more straight roll, no increase, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 20. For this strap, I make 9 rows, and this is how you measure it on your body. For you guys that make bigger size, you can add more rows until you reach the neck part. And for the width of this strap, it is equal to 2.5 inches. And next, we are going to make the round neckline. To begin, count 12 stitches away from the edge and use stitch marker to mark at the 13th stitch. For the measurement of these 12 stitches, it is equal 3 inches. It measuring from the top of the shoulder until you reach below the collarbone. If you guys want your neckline more deeper, you can count more stitches. And next, we are going to make the curve part at the neckline. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 21, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet back loop only for 15 stitches. Then continue, make half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches from the stitch marker. And then we are going to make decrease by make half double crochet 2 together. To make half double crochet decrease, yarn over, insert a hook into the back loop of the stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Then continue, insert the hook into the next loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 4 loops on your hook. Then yarn over and pull through all 4 loops. Next, for row 22, chain 2, turn your work. Then we are going to make decrease again. After you have made decrease, then don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this decreasing stitch to make sure where your last stitch is. And then continue, make half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you reach the single crochet stitch. Then continue, make single crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And for the next row, please keep repeating row 21 and row 22 until you reach row 24. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 24 and after you have made 4 rows of decreasing stitch. And next, for row 25 until row 32, just make no more row but repeat like row 2 and row 3, no decrease, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 32. And this is how you're measuring it on your body. For you guys the bigger size, you can add more rows until you reach the other side of the neck. Then we are going to make the other curved part. We are going to make 4 rows of increasing stitch. It's the same number like we made decrease for 4 rows. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 33, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet back loop only for 15 stitches. And then continue make half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you have one last stitch. And then we are going to make increase by make 2 half double crochet in the same loop. And after you got 2 half double crochet in the same loop, next for row 34, chain 2, turn your work, and we are going to make increase again by make 2 half double crochet in the same loop. And after you got 2 half double crochet in the same loop, then continue make half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you reach the single crochet stitch. Then make single crochet back loop only until you reach the end of the row. And after you reach the end of the row, for the next row, please keep repeating row 33 and row 34 until you reach row 36, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 36. You must have 4 rows, the same number like the other side. And next, we are going to make another strap part. As you can see, for this neckline part, we have 13 stitches that we skipped. And for the other side, you have to make the same number. Next, for row 37, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet back loop only for 15 stitches. Then continue make half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then we are going to continue make 13 chains. It's the same number like the other side that we skipped 13 stitches. After you got 13 chains, then continue add 2 more chains. It is for the turning chain. Next, for row 38, skip 2 chains and make half double crochet into the third chain. Keep making half double crochet into every chain until you reach the end of the chain. And after you reach the end of the chain, then continue make half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you reach the single crochet stitch. Then make single crochet back loop only until you reach the end of the row. After you reach the end of the row, next for row 39 until row 46, you just make no more row but repeat like row 2 and row 3, then we meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 46. For this strap part, I have 9 rows, it's the same number like the other side. Remember, make sure that both straps have the same number of the rows. And next, we are going to make the other arm part to the other side. For the strap part, which is the shoulder part, we have 22 stitches. And for the other side, you have to count 22 stitches and use stitch marker to mark at the 23rd stitch. And next, for row 47, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet back loop only for 15 stitches. Then continue make half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches from the stitch marker. And after you have 2 last stitches, then we are going to make decrease. And next, for row 48, chain 2. strengthen your work and may decrease. After you have made decrease, then continue with half double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you reach single crochet stitch, then make single crochet back loop only until the end of the row. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And now you must have two rows of decreasing stitch. It is the same number like the other side that we made increase for two rows. And next, we are going to make the straight row by start from row 49 until row 57. Just make normal row by repeat like row 2 and row 3. Then we meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 57. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For this straight part, you must have 9 rows, the same number like the other side. And now we are done for the front part of the top. And this is what it looks like. And next, we are going to make the back part of the top. For the back part of the top, we repeat the same thing like the front part. It's just a little bit different at the shoulder part. So first, we make 37 chains, the same number like the front part. And then make normal ribbing stitch for 9 rows. And then make increase for 2 rows. And for the shoulder part, you just make 24 chains. And then make normal ribbing stitch for 35 rows, so you don't have to make the curve part or the back neckline part just a straight row. For you guys that make different size, you just keep making the straight row until you got the same measurement of the front shoulder part by measuring from the first strap until the second strap, as you can see. And next, we are going to make the other underarm part by skip 22 stitches and make decrease for 2 rows. And then make normal ribbing stitch for 9 rows. In total, you must have 57 rows, the same number like the front part. And after you have made the back part, and next we are going to attach the strap with the back part together. So for the strap part, we made 9 rows. And for the back part, you have to count 9 rows from the edge and use stitch marker to mark at the 9th row. Don't forget to count the same number to the other side. To begin, insert the hook into the corner stitch of the strap. And then continue insert the hook into the stitch where we marked. Then attach the yarn into both parts. Next, chain 1 and we are going to make single crochet both sides together. To make single crochet both sides together, insert the hook into both sides loop. Yarn over and pull through both loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then yarn over and pull through all the loops. Keep repeating this by making single crochet both sides together into every stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. after you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. And next, chain one and cut off the yarn. And this is what the right side looks like. Next, please repeat the same thing to the other strap. And now we are done attach both parts together. And next, we are going to attach this both side of the top together by attach the yarn into both corner stitch. Then chain one and continue make single crochet both sides together into every stitch until the end of the row. And after you reach the end of the row, then chain one and cut off the yarn. And this is what it looks like. Please repeat the same thing to the other side. And next, turn your top right side out. And now we are done for the top. And this is what it looks like. And you can make single crochet as a border around the armhole by attach the yarn into the underarm part, then make single crochet into this half double crochet row and into this V loop, and also in this half double crochet row. Keep repeating this by make single crochet into each half double crochet row around until the end of the row. Then make slip stitch with the first stitch, chain one and cut off the yarn. And next, we are going to make the cowl neck. So at the neck part, I have 17 rows. You have to split it into two parts by count 8 rows and mark at the 9th row, which is the middle part of the neckline. And for the other side, we have 8 rows the same, and the 9th row is at the middle part. Next, attach the yarn into the middle part, which is where we use stitch marker to mark. For row 1, chain 2. For chain 2, we don't count as a stitch. Then make double crochet into the same loop where we attach the yarn. To make double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Then yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then yarn over and pull through 2 loops again. This is how we make double crochet stitch. Keep making double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then we meet you back again. Thank you. this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. Then we are going to continue mid slip stitch into the first stitch. To mid slip stitch, continue insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. And next, for row 2, chain 2, turn your work and make double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the first stitch. And for the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 10, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 10. For the measurement from row 1 until row 10, it is equal 4 inches length. If you guys want your cowl neck more longer, you can add more rows. And this is what the cowl neck should look like. And next, we are going to make the hood by continue from where your last stitch is. For row 11, chain 2, turn your work, and we are going to make the double crochet decrease. To make double crochet decrease, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then yarn over and continue insert the hook into the next loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 4 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and now you must have 2 double crochet with 3 loops on the hook. Then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And this is how we make the double crochet decrease. Then make the double crochet into the next loop. And don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at that first double crochet stitch. Remember, for this decreasing stitch, we are going to skip it. Keep making the double crochet into every stitch around until you have 2 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. And after you have 2 last stitches, then we are going to make the double crochet decrease. And after you have made the decrease, next, for row 12, chain 2, turn your work. And we are going to make decrease by skip 1 stitch, then a chain 2, and make decrease into the next stitch. After you have made decrease, then continue make double crochet into every stitch around until you have 2 last stitches from the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. And after you have 2 last stitches from the stitch marker, then we are going to make decrease again. After you have made decrease, and for the next row, please keep repeating row 12 until you reach row 14, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 14. And next, from row 15 until row 45, you just pick a normal row. By chain 2, turn your work and make the bokeh shape into every stitch until the end of the row. Just make a straight row until you reach row 45. That will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 45. For the measurement from row 15 until row 45, it is equal 15.5 inches length. It measuring from the top part of the shoulder until the top of your head. If you want it more longer, please add more rows. And for these 10 rows of the cowl neck, you don't have to measuring it with the hood, and it should look like this. And next, I'm gonna show you how to make the curved corner at the top part of the hood. To begin, fold the hood into two pieces, then use stitch marker to mark at the middle part of it. Next, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 46, chain 2, turn your work and make the bokeh shape into every stitch until you have two last stitches from the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. And after you have two last stitches from the stitch marker, then make the bokeh shape decrease. And next, for row 47, chain 2, turn your work, skip one stitch and make decrease. Remember, for decreasing stitch, you have to skip it. And then continue make the bokeh shape into every stitch until the end of the row. And after you make the bokeh shape until the end of the row, for the next row, you just keep repeating row 46 and row 47 until you reach row 49, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 49. You must have 4 rows of decreasing stitch, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn.
And next, we are going to make decrease to the other side by start working from the stitch where we mark. To begin, attach the yarn into the stitch that needs stitch marker. For row 1, chain 2, then make decrease. And next, continue make the bokeh shape into every stitch until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again.
After you reach the end of the row, and next, for row 2, chain 2, turn your work and make the bokeh shape into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches, then make decrease. And for the next row, please keep repeating row 1 and row 2 until you reach row 4, then I will meet you back again. This is what it looks like after you reach row 4, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And next, we are going to attach this top edge of the hood together.
To begin, turn the hood inside out. Then attach the yarn into the corner stitch. Chain 1 and make single crochet both sides together into every stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again.
And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please weave in into the stitch. Then turn your hood right side out. And this is what the right side looks like. And now hooded cowl top is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Subscribe to my channel and don't forget to follow me on my social medias. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.